So in this particular tutorial, I'm going to make a seascape where there will be some bit of a Strom look and feel, and there is a ship which is going through. So let's have this video, and I hope you'll enjoy this watercolor learning session. And we want to have the stormy clouds here coming across like this, that is passing through, and there's waves, sea waves. Excuse me, just striking the ship, and very rough water. So this is what we have. All right, so this is the sketch we have. So before starting the first layer, I want to talk about my classes available in Skillshare. So you can just browse through those Skillshare classes, and you can learn, you can improve your watercolor in a much higher level. So you can just move from one level to another, and this is how we grow, right? So please check out that Skillshare class. If you don't know about the Skillshare, then let me explain you. The Skillshare is the online learning community for creators with more than 25,000 classes in design, art, and business, and many more. So it's just like, whether you want to fuel your curiosity, creativity, or even career, Skillshare is the perfect place to keep you learning and thrive in 2019. So please go and check out the Skillshare website. So you can get the subscription of Skillshare is less than $10 a month, which is remarkable. Like, you are accessing a thousand of classes, within a $10, which is amazing, isn't it? And interestingly, the first 500 of my subscriber to use the link in the description will get 2 free months of trial version, which is amazing. So guys, please check out the Skillshare and try to subscribe. Try to enroll the course, which will really add a lot of value to you. So premium membership gives you an unlimited access, so you can join the classes and community that are just right for you and your new year goals. So let's go ahead with the first layer. So what I'm going to do here is I am just putting a plain water here on the paper. And after putting the, I'm using this sepia, and I'll also be using ultramarine blue. So just straight away, I'll just put it here, the color. And this color, again the stromy feel of it. And I'm just putting one more water here. and just covering the entire place. Some more depth. I'll just sprinkle a little of water. And I just keep a little bit of this white, which is important here, so try to leave it as it is somewhere with white. So those are actually a wave. And I'm just using a little green. And adding a little ultramarine blue. And that's fine. So we have our first layer ready. So don't get scared if you are having something like this at the end of the first layer. Don't be surprised, because this is how you will have the result. So let it dry completely. Don't work on this, still it's a wet. If you were planning to do a wet on wet, then you can do it, but we don't have any plan to do it in a wet on wet. So let's stick with the dry technique. So I'll let it dry completely, and then we'll go for the second layer.